I'm extremely grateful to Life Positive, to Aditya ji, and the entire team. I'm afraid with the holy brains, holy not in the yesterday sense, not in the why sense, but the ones which has a lot of holes, with my holy brains, I've forgotten the name, so I'm so sorry indeed. So I'm extremely grateful to Aditya ji and all of you for giving me this opportunity of coming over here and being with you, spending an afternoon together. As a classical dancer, and let me start on a different note. You know, normally, I'm always asked, you know, as to why classical dance? What is so great about classical dance? Why was there an importance of classical dance? The fact is that somewhere we are all seeking. We are seeking a balance within ourselves and a balance and a harmony with surroundings. And if I look at classical dance and music, obviously anything, it brings about that beautiful resonance within yourself, it helps you to bring about an equilibrium and a balance within the opposing polarities within yourself and also with the surroundings. In our Indian philosophy, and being a Kathak, I'm always saying that this recognition of within us, we do have the Tandav aspect and we do have the Lasya. The two complete opposite polarities, I'm not talking in terms of Tandav dance or Lasya and Ritya, but in terms of Mishkad, in terms of opposing polarities, the question is how do we bring about a balance between the two? Once we are, and we are always searching for that balance. You see that around us, that there is so much of disharmony around, and we are seeking, so we find our own ways and means of how to bring about that harmony and balance. And perhaps that is what spirituality is all about, to elevate yourself, to find that inner equilibrium and an equilibrium with the surroundings. To elevate yourself, to find that equilibrium. If I look again as a classical dancer, if I'm looking into the world of our Indian philosophy seen through the eyes of dance, I find that this has been the essence in, I do not know how many philosophies in the world really think upon our deities as great performing artists. We look upon them because, again, the arts is something that which brings about that harmony or achieves or tries to move towards that. If I look upon Lord Nataraj, I mean as Shiva, as Nataraj, he's a symbol of an artist. He has the damru in his hand. He dances to the sound, the eternal sound of the nad coming out of the mridang, the rhythm of the cosmos. And there, he's dancing the dance of creation. Here it is. At the same time, we do understand that in that, I'll come to that later, but if I'm thinking of even Lord Krishna, here he has a flute in his hand, he's the Natwar Krishna. If I think about Goddess Saraswati, even though she's the Devi of learning, she's not imbued with books, heavy books in her hands, but the Veena. And perhaps these are imageries that make us understand and think about the necessity of bringing about that equilibrium, that harmony within ourselves. If I bring that within myself, automatically, I'm also reflecting that harmony with my surroundings. Having said that, let me come to the dance form that I do. And I'm going to take a little bit of time because earlier I thought I would be giving some demonstrations to recorded music, but I thought, what is better than live music? So I just told my musicians to come, and I'm extremely grateful to them that they're making efforts to come and be here. So if you can bear with me for 10, 15 minutes, they'll be here. If I think about Kathak, this word, when I do a piece, a pattern in Kathak, or let me start with the origin of even its basic form. It started off how? With the Brahmins in the temples who were narrating stories in praise of the Lord. Why? What was the necessity? To guide you, to guide everyone, to take you to that level where you are one with the Almighty. Through those stories, through the, again, imparting values and a certain kind of a direction. It is the direction which is, you know, it was giving. And in that process, these priests, some of these priests got into a state of ecstasy and started using gesticulation and mime, which automatically later on came to be known as Kathak. You have the Kathak, the Kathakars. Arthur Berrydale Keith has said there are two kinds of Kathaks. Ek to Pathak Kathak hai, jo pad-pad ke kehte hain, baith ke padhte hain, aur kehte hain, kahaniyan kehte hain, katha baachte hain. Aur hum log hain Dharak Kathak, jo patra ko dharan karke, we take on, don the character, and then we tell the story. But that, of course, is, but what is more important is that these Kathaks, there is a purpose. The purpose, I have said, the aim was to elevate their own selves, but at the same time, to elevate the selves of the Shrotas, the listeners. But in that, I'm coming to one thing, that in Kathak, the moment I stand, you know, this I was asked, a question, and let me tell you, I've learned from the greatest of gurus since childhood. Nobody had, when we first stand, we stand like this. I was not aware as to why we took. We, you know, sometimes we accept without questioning. And I was asked, when I was in Gaya, in a little village near the Deoghar Mandir, Deoghar, it was the Shivratri festival and I was performing at Deoghar. And somebody said there is an old Kathak living a few villages away, went to him. And the first question he asked me, you're a Kathak? I said, yes. He says, so am I. I said, yes. That's why I've come to you. He says, tell me, why do we take this position? A simple question that was asked of me, and I had to think. I couldn't come up with an answer. Perhaps we become, you know, and this again talks about all our conditionings. We are conditioned in a certain way that somewhere we ask, but somewhere we never ask. We just accept. So the duality within us is there. We are seeking, and at the same time, we are non-seeking. We are non-seekers. So this little question was asked. And finally he said, this is the Dhyan Mudra. And this Dhyan Mudra becomes the basic mudra of Kathak. And over a period of time, it is this Dhyan Mudra that has been modified to become this. A simple thing about Dhyan Mudra. Why a Dhyan Mudra? Because here, we are again seeking, but the moment we start, we are seeking that connect, that ekagrachit, and that is why dance is taken as a form of yoga. Because isme yam hai, niyam hai, asan, pranayam, pratyahar, dhyan, dharana, samadhi, till you go to that level where you lose yourself. I'm not taking samadhi in the term of just going to the other world, but where you lose yourself. Now, this was a simple thing. And then the next question he asked me, why this movement? This is a very typical Kathak movement. And again, as I said, we accept, we seek, but at the same time, we just accept. And here again, he says, we are Kathaks. We are the medium. The leelas of God that I hand over to you, and it's over a period of time, it's become this. Now, these simple things again show that somewhere we are the link. Now, in this link, we, each one of us is a link between that, those forces and this, and we bring about the equilibrium. One aspect in Kathak, the moment you see in this, the kind of a geometrical figure that is drawn. It's like an arrow wanting to go straight up. So this is that position that here the emphasis is always, the approach is that we want to go up. Go up. That means you're seeking that higher level. It is not the one which is only grounded. Grounded, yes. This brings about it. But the whole attitude is to elevate yourself. Again, another aspect which is quite peculiar and to Kathak is this whole aspect of the Bhramari. The Bhramari, the pirouette. Yes, of course, it's a technical feat, very much so, but technicality, the virtuoso aspect, comes in much later. But it starts off somewhere. There is a need to express, and that need to express later on becomes a kind of a virtuoso feat. And that is that in our Indian philosophy, again, when we are talking of spirituality, we also recognize the fact that life is a full circle. Everything is cyclic. We are. It is, even time is cyclic, as life is cyclic, as everything in this world is cyclic, and therefore this cycle, it's an unending cycle which is continuing. And how best to show it? A philosopher will talk about it. Somebody else will, an artist will probably sculpt it out or paint it out. But we are artists who have invisible canvases to as our treatment. And this space is my canvas where I draw structures through my human body. This space is again my canvas, and the structures drawn, I am painting it with my emotions. And how, and those are the emotions, the sounds and emotions are, is how I paint through it. And that aspect, so the visual interpretation of this philosophy of cyclic philosophy that is so inherent and so much part of our Indian subcontinental philosophy was translated into Kathak. As I said, the need arose somewhere, but later on everything becomes a virtuoso feat. Another aspect, which is very unique to, where again you'll find that here we are. In every art, in our classical dance forms, we begin a piece and we end it off. We take as many cycles as you want, but you will. But if I do a piece, it is almost like unless you don't annihilate it, you cannot start life afresh. So there is a birth, there is a creation, there is that sense of preservation while it's on, but there's also the moment of complete finality, a stop, because in a way that shows its final point where you're annihilating that particular piece, and then again, the next cycle begins. These little philosophical aspects might seem rather, beyond, but again, it's part of a psyche, because then through that, we are learning how to accept the various aspects of life. Now, when talking of spirituality doesn't mean ki main baith ke maine puja paath kar liya. No. It means somewhere we are seeking something to better ourselves, to find that harmony and balance. And here it is that the world of the medium of art, and I'm speaking as a dancer, I find that it helps you to attain that. There are so many times when we say, and this is a age-old Upanishad saying, and which I think is so true, that as long as you're the dancer, you still haven't become one. But when the dancer becomes the dance, that is the point when you have, actually you're on the path of attaining that, what we call samadhi in that whole, in that Ashtang Yoga part of it. So it is that, so the emphasis of all artists, and whether it's in our field of classical art, music, dance, is that we become, we are attempting to become one with that, with the art form, where we lose the swa. Now, this is the point of spirituality. Jab humne apne andar ka jo swa hai, that becomes subjugate. You know, it's subdued, and the form takes over. So we have to, because each one of us has a little bit of swa in it. Swa is important up to a point, but not when it becomes the overriding factor. And that again is one of the aspects of, because spirituality, the point, the word spirituality is not only well-being, but everything, but also helping to, now, to raise yourself, elevate yourself. Madhav, ye yaha hai. Ji. Bahut bahut shukriya. आपको मेरा फोन साइलेंट पे कहा है, बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया. आप हैं उस्ताद शकील अहमद खान, और आप हैं माधव प्रसाद जी. थैंक यू सो मच. थैंक यू. Of the performing arts, which can transport you, transcend it. I think it is also visible in this Maurya period verse related to Kathak, which is the Maurya period inscription, which is there in the Kameshwar archives of Darbhanga, talks about Gangaye Mahanadiye Tate Sabvo Kathaka भिंगारनतेनम स्तुति तीसिकायम एहि राया आदि नाहु भावेनम पसेई. इट मीन्स दैट हियर अगेन इट सेज ऑन द बैंक्स ऑफ द गैंजीज द श्रृंगार नृत्य ऑफ द कथक्स ट्रांसपोर्टेड वाज सो ब्यूटिफुल दैट इट इवन ट्रांसपोर्टेड आदिनाथ. आदिनाथ भाव विभोर पसेई देख रहे थे. So this is the, so here again, transcending it is yourself is one of the main thing which an art form can achieve. It helps you to forget, to elevate yourself. And perhaps that's also the reason why even in the Mahabharata, you'll find the mention of the Kathaks in three different parvas, Adi Parva, Anusasana Parva, and in the Sabha Parva. कथकाश्च परे राजन श्रमणश्च मनोपकस दिव्याख्यानानि ये चापि पठन्ति मधुरं द्विजः. कि वो सो हियर अगेन यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट हाउ द आर्ट फॉर्म ट्रांसपोर्ट्स यू इनटू अनदर रियल्म, एंड थ्रू इट्स विजुअल योर विजुअल खाका खींच करके यू आर नरेटिंग अ स्टोरी, बट एट द सेम टाइम ट्रांसपोर्टिंग नॉट ओनली द परफॉर्मर बट द रसिकर्स ऑल्सो. And that is the important part of it. I would like to, yes, a question that sometimes comes up, that is on stage. Sometimes you're very conscious of the audience. Yes, we are all human beings. You are conscious of the audience. But at the same time, the initial part, you're conscious. But then later on, when you actually become totally immersed, you forget. Because there is a different kumari. There's a different kind of an intoxication, and that is that spiritual intoxication one is talking about. So much so that whether your whatever personal injuries a dancer particularly might suffer with all our gungrus, etc., you really do not come to know until much later. And that, the fact that you're not conscious of injuries to yourself, to your body, which otherwise would make you scream, again is indicates that level of elevation of the inner self, where you have forgotten yourself, where you are no longer who you are, but you are immersed in the rasa, the beauty of something else. This brings me, when the spirituality, as I said, is not something which is ritualistic or something, but it's like rasa. It's rasa. How do you say what rasa is about? It is something that you experience, and in that experiencing process, it is a different process where you forget yourself. If I have your, can I do little tidbits of different aspects? I'll just start with a vandana, just a vandana.
Sarvelo kai kai
As you saw, we always started with this. I would like to do a small little piece where even talking of spirituality, the path, what is it? What are the values? To look beyond yourself, to think about others, to be not only to take but to give. That is important, and I would like to hear, mention one little piece and perhaps do it. First of all, I'd like to mention the piece about Yashodhara teaching her little child and talking about and telling him about his father, telling Rahul who his father was. Who is better? The shikari, the hunter who hunts the bird. Is that his? Is that yours? Is that mine? Or the one who gives it life? And little Rahul talks about, even at that small age, he's talking about the one who gives life, who nurtures life rather than takes life. If that be so, what about his mother, Yashodhara? She, when we, and particularly women say, mujhe yehi nahi mila, aap kyun nahi mere liye karte hain? Why? Each one of us expects others to give, expects others. We have a lot of desires and expectations from others. But what about us? We have to also, can we, are we up to it? Can we give rather than only desire and expect? The moment we do that, we might face momentary pain, but there is greater happiness later on. That experiencing of the rasa of happiness and anand comes later, after that momentary pain. And therefore I would like to just do a small piece, Yashodhara, the story of Lord Buddha's wife. I think some of you may be rather familiar with it, but some of you who are not, particularly the young ones, perhaps I would like to just repeat the story. Lord Buddha, we all know the story of Lord Buddha. I think that's the beautiful example that how he went into attaining enlightenment. After all, he saw the old man, the leper, and the corpse. And he's filled with dismay, all of us, as to why there's so much of pain in life. If it happens to us, we say, why me? Why was I chosen? Each one of us asks this question. And he was talking about, why is there pain in life? And then he sees the peaceful countenance of a yogi. And he's wondering, in this atmosphere of pain and all kinds of anguish, here is a person who is so peaceful, with a peaceful countenance. And that makes him decide to seek enlightenment. But he leaves his wife and his family. And when his wife gets up in the morning and sees he's not there, she looks for him. And she says, but why couldn't he tell me before going? Sakhi ve mujhse kehkar jaate. Sidh hai tu swami gaye, yehi Gaurav ki baat par chori chori gaye. Yehi bada vyakhya, sakhi ve mujhse kehkar jaate. Her thing is, why did he tell me? Why didn't he confide in me before going? After all, I'm the wife of a Rajput. And it's my duty, my dharma, to adorn him, give him the sword and send him to the battlefield from where no one knows whether he'll return. Sakhi, why couldn't he confide in me? But when she sees him at her doorstep, years later of course, and after he's attained Buddhahood, she's happy, elated that her husband's come. But alas, no. He comes before her as the bhikshuk seeking bhiksha. And then she says, but bhiksha? What do I? You want bhiksha. This is material. These material things don't mean a thing. When I have lost what I would like, which would give me inner happiness, she says, the only thing which I can give you as bhiksha is donating our son Rahul. And she donates Rahul as bhiksha to his father. And here is the supreme sacrifice who found happiness in that great sacrifice.
Ji.
No talking.
Buddham sharanam gacchami, dhammam sharanam gacchami, sangham sharanam gacchami, gacchami, gacchami. स्वामी गए ये गौरव के पर चोरे चोरे गए पर चोरे चोरे गए ये ही बड़ा भ्यागा सके वे मुझसे कह कर जा वे मुझसे कह कर जा स्वयं सुसज्जित करके क्षण में प्रीतम को प्राणों के प्रण में स्वयं सुसज्जित करके क्षण में प्रीतम को प्राणों के प्रण हमें भेज दे तिहरण में छात्र धर्म के नाते सखे वे मुझसे कह कर जाते वे मुझसे कह कर जाते वे मुझसे कह कर जाते कह कर जाते पधारो भव भव के भगवान पधारो भव भव के भगवान पधारो भव भव के भगवान रख ली मेरी लज्जा तुमने रख ली मेरी लज्जा तुमने आओ अत्र भवान पधारो भव भव के भगवान पधारो भव भव के भगवान नाथ विजय यही तुम्हारी नाथ विजय यही तुम्हारी दिया तुझको गौरव भारी दिया तुझको गौरव भारी अपनाए मुझसे लघुनारी अपनाए मुझसे लघुनारी होकर महा महान पधारो भव भव के भगवान पधारो भव भव के भगवान 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 दीन न हो गोपे हीन नहीं नारी कभी बतलाऊं मैं क्या अधिक तुम्हें तुम्हारा कर्म पाला है तुमने जिसे वही वधू का धर्म पाला है तुमने जिसे, वही वधू का धर्म कृत कृत हुई गोपा पाया यह योग भोग। अब जा तू, अब जा तू, आ राहुल बड़ बेटा, पूज्य पिता से परंपरा पा तू, पूज्य पिता से परंपरा पा तू। इच्छामि संगम शरणम गच्छामि, बुद्धम शरणम गच्छामि, संगम धम्मम शरणम गच्छामि, संगम शरणम गच्छामि, बुद्धम शरणम गच्छामि, धम्मम शरणम गच्छामि, संगम शरणम गच्छामि।
Talking of Buddha, I think his on his path to Buddhahood, the lesson that he learned from the artists of that time, I think that is something which all of us need to dwell upon. While he was, and I think it's so true of each one of us, we tend to go here, we tend to go there, we tend to take our extremes. The middle path. How do we bring about that harmony and equilibrium that we are talking about, that I have been talking about, that our arts talks about? And that was perhaps one of the keys that he got his Buddhahood, the enlightenment. When he heard an artist, a young, while he was meditating, he heard ki kisi ka sitar jo hai, wo us samay zamane ki veena, tar zyada kas diya tha. And then the string broke. Then he says, utna zyada kaso mat. He heard the guru say, zara zyada hi dheela ho gaya, besura ho gaya. So he says, utna dheela bhi mat karo ki besura ho jaye. So you need, so he says, just tune it tight, just make it enough tight that it keeps the melody and the harmony and the string does not break. Wow. So that was the middle path that he heard, and finally he came to his preaching of the middle path. But it's important because we, each one of us, tend to forget to bring about that balance and harmony in our lives, and therefore we are all over. I don't want to do two pieces of Buddha, so one was enough. But I would like to mention again another person. We all know in our through our dance forms, we ourselves are learning every day. While we are narrating stories, but we are also learning every day. Wo Kabir wala hai? Uske andar hoga. When Kabir, he talks about ki aap jo hai, we have to again bring about, because in a Hari mere mein the, when I said I was I, then Hari was nowhere to be seen. But the moment I said Hari is there, then I am gone. Jab main tha, Hari nahi, ab Hari hai, to main nahi.
Wow.
And that is the most beautiful part of it, that even us as performers are constantly learning different aspects of bringing about that in that balance within ourselves. Our sur teaches us ki agar wo sur mein wo baat na ho to fir kaise ho sake. Wo agar you know, we have our notes, there has to be harmony within the tabla, the harmonium, the dancer, everything is balanced. So, and here again, Kabir so beautifully has put it and says, the moment we, jab main tha hari nahi, ab hari hai, to main nahi, mila ki nahi.
Main to hoon hari nahi.
Kabir nahi mile kya? Aise kaagzo mein. Game with my lord.
जी
मिल गया, कौन सा वाला मिला?
कबीर, कबीर जी,
कबीर मिल गया जी, मिल गया. माधव, क्योंकि छोटा छोटा है तो फिर दो वर्सेस या तीन वर्सेस कर लेते हैं.
पलकों की चिक दारी के पिया को ले अर जाए प्रिया को ले अर जाए। जब मैं था तब हरे नहीं अब हरी है मैं नहीं अब हरी है मैं नहीं। दुख में सुमिरन सब करे सुख में करे ना कोई। दुख में सुमिरन सब करे दुख में सुमिरन सब करे दुख में सुमिरन दुख में दुख में सुमिरन सब करे सुख में करे ना कोई। दुख में सुमिरन सब करे सुख में करे ना कोई। जो सुख में सुमिरन करे दुख काहे कोहे 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 जो सुख में सुमिरन करे दुख काहे को दुख काहे को। जब मैं था तब हरे नहीं अब मैं हूँ हरे नहीं। जब मैं था तब हरे नहीं अब हरी है मैं नहीं अब हरी है मैं नहीं अब हरी है मैं नहीं।
Here again we are talking about that we can bring about that equilibrium within ourselves the moment we lose that ahem within us. Swa is important up to a point, but ahem, ego, I think agar hum taj de, then we are at peace within ourselves. Aur ek aur kar le? Haan, bilkul, hum ek ka. I'm going to do the holy last. लेकिन एक और मैं इसलिए कह रही थी वो when we are talking about because today when I look around there's lack of understanding of each other there is total deficit of appreciation of diversities there's a total depreciation or a deficit of trust in each other and all this brings about and each one of us wants to be heard but not to hear. How many of us just keep wanting to be heard but are we ready to hear? There was a very beautiful poem I had read a long time ago. I'm talking about, but I don't remember. He says, who's the poor person? He says, I don't remember the poem, but it says, poverty is within you. Poverty is not outside. Yes, those are the economic part of it. But actual poverty is within ourselves. When without, even in spite of all the faculties, we are unable to use them properly. We see, yet we actually don't see. We smell, but actually we don't. We hear, but actually we don't hear. We speak, but actually we don't speak. Everything, you know, it's that, it is just the opposite. So the actual poor person, poverty, lies within our own selves. And we have to look within. And when I think of, and before I'll end off with holy, but before end off, I'd like to mention one more piece. That when I talked about diversities, Amir Khosro says, ki jab hum, I'm playing with my beloved, wo beloved, aur hum khel rahe hain, hum chahte hain ki hum, in this game, I want to lose. Because when I lose, actually I win. So in my losing is my actual winning. Because I become, I am with him. I am at one with him. Aur usi tarah se, a lot of us in our Indian subcontinent, the moment I take the flute, Vishnu, the moment I take the flute, I know that I'm talking about Krishna. And why is Krishna so important to us? It's because unki bansuri ki awaaz se hum bhav vibhor ho uthte hain. Hum unki taraf bhaage chale aate hain. Wo unki bansuri ki awaaz hame sab dukh dardon se dur karti hai aur mujhe kisi aur realm mein le jaati hai. Here again I forget myself. It's elevation. It's elevation of the inner soul that the bansuri of Krishna brings about. And the same sentiment has been said by Rumi. And this is, he says, Bishnu azne chyon hikayat mi kunad az judai ho shikayat mi kunad. Seena khahim shereh shereh asfiraq taab goyim shereh dardesh diak. Says, listen to the plaintive notes of the flute wailing the pangs of separation. Just as the heart of the flute is pierced. That piercing mein se hi hum bajate hain. Just as the heart of the flute is pierced, so is my heart pierced in this ishtiyaq, the desire to be one with you. Says, Har kara jamaz e ishki chaak shud, uze hirso jumla e bhi paak shud. Says, the way we remove our dirty clothes and cleanse ourselves of bodily impurities, actually it's the sound of the flute that cleanses me of my inner impurities. And if you say it's this madness of love, then long live this madness. So it is this message of universal brotherhood, of appreciation of all, that somewhere has taken a backseat, and we need to again awaken that within us. It's there within us, but somewhere it has taken a back seat in humankind, in mankind. So I'll just do this small thing, aur uske baad I'm just at the same time telling him what are, that's the advantage with live musicians, na? So I can ye karne ke baad iske saath saath fir hum theek hai nahi uske saath saath nahi karenge
gap ke
baad karenge theek hai
judai शिकायत में कुना दे अजे जुदाई हो शिकायत में कुना विष्णु अपने चूहे कायत में कुना सेना खाहेम शरहा अज फिराक सेना खाहेम शरहा अज फिराक ताबगोयम शरह दर्दे इश्तियाक ताबगोयम शरह दर्दे इश्तियाक विष्णु अजने चूहे कायत में कुनात विष्णु अजने हर करा दामा इश्क चाक शुद्ध उदे हिस्रो जुमला ए विपाक शुद्ध शाद बाश इश्क खुश सौदाई आए तबीबे जुमला इल्लत होए मा आए तबीबे जुमला इल्लत होए मा आए तबीबे
one of the motives which are so similar. When Meerabai dances, she's got the kartal. When a Sufi dances, he also has one hand up. There's always this connect. We are seeking connection with that ultimate one being. Whether it is Vaishnavism, whether it is Sufism. You see, both are talking of the same thing, same motives, exactly the same imageries, but two different languages, two different isms. But in reality, they are the same. And that is why I said, we have to again seek within ourselves somewhere that we have kept hidden is that sense of sensitivity, connectivity, humanity. And once we awaken that within us, phir ho होली का असली रंग तो तभी आएगा अगर हम उन चीजों को जब तक हम दफना कर रखते हैं अपने अंदर, तब होली का रंग तो ऊपरी है, लेकिन असली रंग होली का तभी निकलेगा अगर हम उसको निखारें और जो ऊपरी जो भेदभाव हमने बनाया है उसको मिटा के रखें, जहां मानवीयता, संवेदना और सहनशीलता और एक दूसरे के लिए आदर और समझ, एक दूसरे को समझना, जब वो प्रक्रिया, वो शक्ति हमारे में जगेगी, तब असली होली होगी। और उसी असली होली की उम्मीद में, जो हमारे स्पिरिचुअलिटी जो कहती है, जिसकी खोज हम कर रहे हैं अपने अंदर, अपने सराउंडिंग्स में, अपने वातावरण में, लेकिन वो वातावरण हम बनाते हैं, वी मेक इट आवरसेल्फ, हम उसी के, आई विल जस्ट एंड इट ऑफ विद दैट, इफ दैट्स ओके विथ यू, और डू वी हैव टाइम फॉर मोर, बिकॉज अदरवाइज वी कैन गो, हाँ, अदरवाइज वी कैन डू अ क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर सेशन। जी, होली, there's one beautiful verse I just remembered. I remembered it and I forgot it. No, I remembered it and I forgot it. Wo umang mein se. एक ही रंग में सब रंग समाए, एक ही रंग में सब रंग समाए, उड़े ला अबीर गुलाल। हम एक रंग में हैं, लेकिन हम अलग अलग, एक दूसरे, भेदभाव है वो हमारे अंदर है, वो बाहर से नहीं होता है, उसको हमें मिटाना है, और उस एक रंग में, वो दैट वन, एक ही प्यार के रंग में रंगना है। चलिए, जो आप कर रहे थे,
मैं तो खेलूंगी, मैं तो खेलूंगी, हाँ मैं तो खेलूंगी उन्हीं से होर गुइया, मैं तो खेलूंगी, हाँ मैं तो खेलूंगी उन्हीं से होर गुइया, मैं तो खेलूंगी लेके अबीर गुलाल कुमकुमा, लेके अबीर लेके लेके अबीर गुलाल कुमकुमा, लय के अबीर गुलाल कुमकुमा रंग से हाँ रंग से हाँ वो तो रंग से भरी पिचकारी गुइयां वो तो रंग से भरी वो तो रंग से हाँ रंग से भरी पिचकारी गुइयां वो तो रंग से भरी पिचकारी गुइयां काना के जाने दे घर जाए घेरू डगर नहीं जाने दे घर ऐसो ढीठ लंगर नहीं माने निडर ऐसो ढीठ लंगर नहीं माने निडर आज शाम सुंदर से रंग मचा आज शाम सुंदर से रंग मचा बिंदा लाऊंगी गहबर जोरी मैं तो खेलूंगी ओ मैं तो खेलूंगी उन्हीं से हो रे गुइयां मैं तो खेलूंगी उन्हीं से हो रे गुइयां मैं तो खेलूंगी उन्हीं से हो रे गुइयां मैं तो खेलूंगी हाँ मैं तो खेलूं उन्हीं से हो रे गुइयां मैं तो खेलूंगी 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 मैं तो खेलूंगी उन्हीं से हो रे गुइयां मैं तो खेलूंगी से हो रे गुइयां मैं तो खेलूं उन्हीं से हो रे गुइयां मैं तो खेलूंगी हाँ मैं तो खेलूंगी उन्हीं से हो रे होली खेलत नंदलाल बिरज में होली खेलत नंदलाल बिरज में होली खेलत नंदलाल भर पिचकारे मुख पे मारे नहीं मानत नंदलाल भर पिचकारे मुख पर मारे नहीं मानत नंदलाल होली खेलत नंदलाल बिरज में होली खेलत नंदलाल रे होली खेलत हाँ होली खेलत हाँ होली खेलत नंदलाल बिरज में होली खेलत नंदलाल एक ही रंग में बहुरंग समाए एक ही रंग बहुरंग समाए ओढ़ेला अबीर गुलाल एक ही रंग में बहुरंग समाए ओढ़ेला अबीर गुलाल होली खेलत होली खेलत नंदलाल बिरज में होली खेलत नंदलाल रे होली खेलत नंदलाल बिरज हाँ होली खेलत नंदलाल बिरज रे होली खेलत नंदलाल बिरज में होली खेलत नंदलाल होली है
कहीं भी ले आओ।
ये होली का रंग, ये होली का रंग, मानवीयता का रंग, भाईचारे का रंग, सभी रंग हैं दुनिया में, और उससे हमें अपने आप को रंगना है। And I think that's the, if we understand it, we've tread half the path towards that path towards spirituality. I think that was a small, you know, I just did 3 or 4 pieces with different messages, different aspects of this path towards spirituality. And if there's any questions, I'm here. Sure. No, no, not at all. I prefer standing.
My name is Anurup. So I just want to understand what are the boundaries within which you have to operate, those boundaries, and where do you see Kathak evolving to in its next version of evolution?
Definitely. Kathak has always been ever evolving. The Kathak that we see being done today was very different from the Kathak of my childhood. And I'm sure it was very different from the Kathak of the preceding centuries. I do not know what the Kathak of the Maurya period was, where I was quoting at that inscription. I do not know what the Kathak and how they performed during the period of the Mahabharata. After all, they find mention in the Mahabharata. But what is clear is that thread of Atma, that soul of Kathak, continues till today. Now you talked about the boundaries. Let me. Particularly of Kathak is concerned, we have the Sanchari Bhav. Sanchari Bhav is that, you know, of this main Bhav, you are the related episodes, etc., that go to it. So those are the boundaries which most of the dance forms, or in fact, all the classical dance forms follow. But Kathak, in a way, goes beyond. Particularly if you see an aspect known as Bhav Batana. I am now. It depends on me. How immersed am I in that genre of that emotion? What is the depth of my understanding? What is the depth of my feeling? And that opens different vistas of interpretation. And this is the most unique part of Kathak, which you don't see in various other places. For example, I'll take a small, just one line. Attariya pe chad gai, main ho gai badnaam. I think most of you are Hindi bhashis over here. Do tell me, what does it mean? Attariya pe chad gai, main ho gai badnaam. Kiski imagery aati hai?
Kotha.
Kotha, bilkul sahi. Attariya, you are climbing the, because traditionally the kotha is always up over there. That's why it's called the kotha. And the kotha is inhabited by who? A dancing girl. Attariya pe chad gai, main ho gai badnaam. And this reminds me also, I'll go on to the Bhav Batana later. I'm just digressing a piece. That Vivekanand, when he went to that Raja, was it of Alwar or whoever, and where he was told that aaj shaam ko mehfil hai. Wahi, the wife ko hi aayegi. To woh mehfil hai, aur aap jo hai, aayye. He says, nahin, nahin. Ye sab mere liye nahin. I'm a swami. These the wives and the dance. And when she sang, Prabhuji, mere avagun chitna dharo. So when she sang that, Prabhuji mere, seedhi pukar thi waha. And he who had shunned her and gone away came back and said, who am I to stand in judgment? When here is the purity of a soul crying out through that beautiful bandish, Prabhuji, mere avgun chitna dharo. Now, I digress it, but I want to say that the Kothewalis are usually taken to be those. So now you talked about the boundaries. Boundaries, it depends on me as my how deeply involved. Now, अटरिया पे चढ़ गई मैं हो गई बदनाम. मैं सिर्फ एक एक लाइन ले रही हूं एक 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 वर्स का. आई कैन डू इट कि अटरिया पे चढ़ गई. आई एम द वाइफ, हां यू आर द वन हु इज कमिंग अप. अटरिया पे चढ़ गई एंड आई हैव आई एम लाइक दिस अ सिंपलटन. बट द मोमेंट आई गो अप टू द अटरिया, एवरीवन नोज that she's available. Atariya, so I can go, that simile can go on. In the Sanchari Bhav, I can do Atariya pe chadh gayi, how I don't want to go, I'm there, and suddenly somebody comes and says, dance and, you know, or sing or whatever. So my Sanchari Bhav can take different realms, different circumstances. But I'll go to another realm. Suppose I consider myself an adornment. I become synonymous with Shringar. Not a woman. I've gone beyond it. I'm a Shringar. I'm Shringar per se. Ab jab tak this one was there, my earrings were there, it was looking nice, na? Now it's not there. But it's lying. So atariya pe chadh gayi. Now I'm the earring. अटरिया पे चढ़ गई. अरे हाउ ब्यूटिफुल यू आर लुकिंग, लुक एट दोज ब्यूटिफुल इयररिंग्स. मैं हो गई बदनाम. बदनाम इन द सेंस दैट पीपल हैव बिकम अप्रिशिएटिव, दे नू. बदनाम इन नॉट इन द बदनाम सेंस, बट बदनाम. सपोज द दिस इज द बिंदी. अटरिया पे चढ़ गई, मैं हो गई बदनाम. और हियर इज अ सिंदूर. एज लॉन्ग एज इट्स इन द बॉक्स, it has, what is its identity? But it climbs. Atariya pe, it's climbing. Atariya pe chad gayi, main ho gayi badnaam. Everyone knows that she's a married woman. Atariya pe chad gayi, main ho gayi badnaam. So I can go into the different realms of even I becoming synonymous with Shringar. Now let's go to another level. I am a flame. The moment the flame is, if it's just a match stick or a matchbox, so what's it? But the moment Atariya pe chadh gayi, main ho gayi badnaam, I'm spreading light. A candle, Atariya pe chadh gayi, main ho gayi badnaam, and look at the moths that are coming over there. Atariya pe chadh gayi, main ho gayi badnaam. And the moment, what's climbing up now? The smoke, the curling smoke. Atariya pe chadh gayi, main ho gayi badnaam. I had been burning over there. I'll come to another level, a philosophical level. Our last journey. Atariya pe chadh gayi. So it depends on us. It depends. And again, this is the Abhinaya portion. But I can also take the realms into the rhythmic portion. For me, the rhythmic part of Kathak is not just pure rhythm that I'm doing something, a pattern. That also has an imagery. That is also a living being, because it has a birth, it has a life of its own, emotions of its own, and it has an end. For example, if I had to take the two dancers, the two great dancers, Shiv and Krishna. Ek ke haath mein damru, ek ke haath mein bansuri. एक एंड बोथ आर नर्तक्स डांसिंग टू द साउंड ऑफ द मृदंग. नाउ लुक एट दिस, नाउ दिस इमेजरी. Here's the flute being thrown up and he picks it up and plays the bansuri. So even in the patterns, in the rhythmic patterns, there is a mood in it and imagery in it. But it depends on us. How we it is like, you know, you have all the material around. It depends. It's a language. The alphabets are there. Depends on you. How much immersed are you to take it forward?
Yeah.
My personal experience has been that even the initiated audience will understand. I mean, I'm not even talking, but we are talking about the uninitiated. Uninitiated understands it. The moment, if something is good, it attracts you. If something is bad, automatically even the uninitiated know it's bad. But the moment you do it, and you, I have found in my, I'm not going to tell you my age, but whatever it is, in so many 45 years of actual stage performance, professional stage performance, that is not as a child artist, but professional stage performance, 45 years, I found that when you do it, even a school child knows it, understands it, comes to you, is able to relate to it, and so many times they have just come up and said, we never knew it. Those eyes, they spoke this, that, this one, and their interpretation of what you had done was amazing, because they, most of them, I would say 90% of them, just hit the nail on the head. So it depends. If there is sincerity in what you do, that sincerity reaches out. And that sincerity first reaches out with its, with the artistry and with its sincerity, and therefore draws you. It's like, sort of invisible vibrations, which is there in the air, but you have to, the patra has to be there, but it has to be good, you know, even the sender has to have the strong signals, and the receiver also has to have at least part of it to be able to receive it. And I found that, yes, if it is sincere, if it comes from here, if it's superficial, then I'm sorry, then it just goes off. But if it comes from here, it does. It does. And therefore, that initial drawing opens the door to a greater interest in knowing a little more about it. But we are talking about the uninitiated, and I found that it does happen. But the only trouble is that most of them do not get the opportunity, or have not been able to receive the opportunity at home or in their immediate surroundings to be able to see. And because it's like a good sur. Agar sur agar achhi tarah se lage to aha. आदमी ऐसे ऐसे हो जाता है तो बट द मोमेंट दे गेट द अपॉर्चुनिटी वो बात है. देयर इज अ रिसीवर, दैट रिसीवर एंटीना इज देयर अमंगस्ट एवरीवन, विद इन एवरीवन. जी,
माय नेम इज प्रहलाद शेखावत, आई एम अ राइटर एंड फ्रीलांस जर्नलिस्ट. I am Prahlad Shekhawat. I am a writer and freelance journalist. I just wanted to know the what you describe as losing yourself, which in psychology is called sense of flow, when you lose a sense of time and place. But that can also be in the secular sense, or what one would could call secular spirituality. But there is also what you seem to describe as the spiritual path to divinity or divine spirituality. Do you make the distinction between the two? Flow as losing yourself.
What is divine actually? God, I can call God by XYZ depending on which faith I am in. But the divinity is there within us. And you know, whether it is secular spirituality or divinity within us, I think I'll just, a poem I had learnt in my childhood and which I've never forgotten. I would like to just, if you, most of us, at least of that era, had read this poem, Abu Ben Adam. And he talked about that Abu Ben Adam, may his tribe increase, awoke one night from a deep dream of peace and saw within the moonlight in his room, making it rich like a lily in bloom, an angel writing in a book of gold. Exceeding peace had made Ben Adam bold. And to the vision in the room he said, what writest thou? The vision raised its head and answered, the names of those who love the Lord. And is mine one? Asked Abu. Nay, not so, replied the angel. Then Abu spoke more low, but clearly still, and said, I pray thee then, write me as one who loves his fellow men. The angel wrote and vanished. Next night it came again with a great awakening light, and showed the names whom love of God had blessed. And lo, Ben Adam's name led all the rest. So it is that the divinity is within us. The spirituality is within us. The secular divinity, the secular spirituality is within us. It is for us to awaken it, to understand it. And as I said, we don't need to go to temples. We don't need to go to follow rituals to show that how... or to the church, or to whatever places of worship. Again, I'm come back to what Vivekananda had said. We had courtesy Professor Ramchandra Gandhi, the grandson of Mahatma Gandhi, who treated me like a younger second sister in the family. And he had, from the lives of the great sages, he had written 7 plays for me, and he would himself say it out, and I would enact it out. And in Vivekananda, he says, he called it the temptation of Vivekananda. And and it is from Vivekananda's own saying, in where he says, when he went to Shir Bhavani and saw the broken idols, and he says, I've come all this way to look at you. When you can't, Devi, you can't even put your own house in order, protect yourself. So why have I come to pay worship to you, to pay you obeisance? And he says, he felt as though a voice of the Devi had told him, says, who are you to question? Look at you. You have people all around you. Do not allow X or Y to come into and pray to me, or X, because we are creating man-made discriminations. And when that is there, so who are you? Others who have come and destroy the idols do not understand our faith, but you who understand our faith are part of it, yet you practice discrimination. And that is what he said. Because at that time, point of time, Vivekananda says, Devi, I'm tempted to deny your existence. And that's when he felt that the Devi spoke to him. So that is what, as I said, that if we awaken that inner sense of compassion, of sensitivity, humanity, why only to beings, human beings? Why not to all beings, to environment around? We are not doing it, and that's why you have the calamities. And we are the modern day Dushasans. Dushasan bas karo, dharti ka cheer haran mat karo, phir dwapar ko dohrane ka dussahas mat karo, Dushasan bas karo, bas karo, bas karo.
Shobhna ji, just one comment, you know. One comment and one question, which is a short one because I think time is running out. Wo hindi mein bolunga, jo udgar hain jisko kehte hain. To wo अश्विनी भिड़े देशपांडे ने एक होली गाई थी, पता नहीं आपने सुनी है कि नहीं, वो है कैसी होली मचाई कन्हाई अचरज लखियो न जाई। अब मैं उसकी पैरोडी सुना रहा हूं, कैसी होली मचाई शोभना जी अचरज लखियो न जाई, सुध बुध सब बिसराई। दैट इज माई कॉम्प्लीमेंट टू योर परफॉर्मेंस। द अदर क्वेश्चन विच आई हैव बीन यू नो वॉन्टिंग टू आस्क यू फॉर क्वाइट सम टाइम, राइट फ्रॉम द डेज ऑफ द अकेडमी, that you are a leader, you are a civil servant, you are a physicist, you are an guru, you are an acclaimed dancer, and now you have become recently a mother-in-law. Now how do you integrate all of that? Answer if you may feel like. Thank you. It is, to me it seems to be physically impossible to do all that what you do. Thank you.
I'm sorry, everyone is everything. Each one, each person in this room is doing multitasking, and they're different personas at different places. It just, and each one of us is no different, and of course everyone does it. Thank you. And Uma, Suma ji, and everyone concerned with Life Positive, and all esteemed members of this very, very august audience. Wonderful to see each one of you here. Some of you I've known for a very long time, and but each one is a dear friend, and thank you very much for having me here. Thank you. Thank you to Shakil bhai and Madhav ji. Thank you.